So hello everyone, so welcome to my channel. So I'll be your teacher of class 10 mathematics. So I'll be teaching you chapter wise. So first I'll be lecturing on chapter 1, that is real number. So what I have thought is to complete your syllabus within this year. So I will do theory portion and all exercise and optional also, and I will make extra video for the examples and extra questions. Okay, so today our topic is real number. So before going to the topic, so I'll like to highlight some of the basic terms, okay, which is required for this chapter. Okay, so let's start. So before going to the chapter, number one, natural number. Okay, natural number. Natural number. What is natural number? Okay, natural number are those number which are used for countings. Okay, the counting numbers are called natural number. Okay, so the counting numbers are called natural number. Numbers, natural numbers. Okay, so the counting numbers are called natural number. जो आप गिनने में इस्तेमाल करते हैं वही नंबर को हम natural number बोलते हैं. It is denoted by capital N. Okay, it is denoted by or it is represented by capital N. Example, it will be more clear with example. The natural number will start from 1 because we used 1 for counting, not 0, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, comma, dot, dot, dot. इसी तरह ये आगे बढ़ते जाएंगे. जैसे 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, आप कब तक लिखना चाहते हैं, उसी तक आप ये continue होता है. और ध्यान रहे, नेचुरल नंबर 1.5 नहीं होता है, इसके बीच के नंबर नेचुरल नंबर नहीं है क्योंकि वो हम काउंटिंग में इस्तेमाल नहीं करता है. ये तो हुआ नेचुरल नंबर. नंबर टू में होल नंबर, WHOLE होल नंबर. सो व्हाट इज होल नंबर? होल नंबर्स इज the natural number including 0. Natural number में 0 include होना चाहिए, तो तभी तो whole number बनता है. The natural number including 0. Okay, the natural number including 0. So example, 0, 1, 2, 3, comma, dot, 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 goes on, okay? The natural number starts from 1 and whole numbers starts from 0. 0 is a whole number, means the number, complete number. Whole number means the complete number. The natural number is incomplete without 0, okay? So, whole number means 0 must be included. This is the basics of mathematics, okay? So, ye exam mein nahi puchega, लेकिन आपको पता होना चाहिए. वन बाय वन आगे बढ़ते हैं. नंबर थ्री में आप इसे कॉपी पेन के साथ नोट करते जाइए. नंबर थ्री पे इंटीजर्स क्या है? इंटीजर्स वो है पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव नेचुरल नंबर का क्या है, ये कॉम्बिनेशन है इंक्लूडिंग जीरो. डेफिनेशन लिखते हैं, द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव, पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव नेचुरल नंबर इंक्लूडिंग जीरो. ओके, इट इज डिनोटेड बाय बाय इंटीजर जेड. ओके, इस होल नंबर में इट इज डिनोटेड बाय से डब्लू. ओके, ये कुछ फर्क नहीं आएगा. एग्जाम्पल कैसे लिखते हैं ये, क्योंकि ये नेगेटिव और पॉजिटिव नेचुरल नंबर का कॉम्बिनेशन है, इसलिए इसको ऐसा लिखना पड़ेगा डॉट डॉट डॉट, क्योंकि नेगेटिव भी आगे जाते रहेंगे. -3 से लिख देंगे, -3, -2, -1, -0, -1, -2, -3. ओके, ये क्या है, इंटीजर है. देखिए ये क्या है, ये पार्ट पॉजिटिव नेचुरल नंबर है, ये क्या है नेगेटिव नेचुरल नंबर है, और ये क्या है जीरो है. सिंपल डेफिनेशन. ओके, सो इसे हम नंबर लाइन में भी लिख सकते हैं, कैसे रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं, आपने एलिमेंट्री क्लास में देखा होगा. सो एक लाइन है, स्ट्रेट लाइन है. ये स्ट्रेट लाइन क्या दिखा रहा है, ये इधर तक जाते रहेंगे इन्फिनिटी तक, और अब हम इस पॉइंट को हम जीरो मान सकते हैं, ऑरिजिन मान सकते हैं. जीरो के बाद 1, 2, 3, 4 आप पूरे तो नहीं लिख सकते, आप इतने तक लिख सकते हैं, और जितना गैप है उतना आप मेंटेन कीजिए. -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. ये सिंपल नंबर लाइन रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ इंटीजर, ऐसे होता है. ओके, सो इंटीजर भी हुआ, और हम आगे बढ़े, 3 हुआ और 4 नंबर पे आएगा रैशनल नंबर. ओके, RATIONAL, रैशनल नंबर. एक चीज अब देखिए, नंबर लाइन में आपने क्लास 9 पे देखा होगा कि आप 0 और 1 के बीच में इनफाइनाइट नंबर होता है. ओके, रैशनल नंबर इनफाइनाइट होता है, माने इसके अंदर आपका नंबर बहुत सारे होते हैं, लेकिन हम क्या बात कर रहे हैं, नेचुरल नंबर इस नंबर को इंक्लूड नहीं करता है, क्योंकि वो काउंटिंग नंबर है. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. ओके, सो नेचुरल नंबर का कॉम्बिनेशन है ये ऐसा होगा, ना कि 0.1 नहीं होगा. आप इसे नोट कीजिए, रैशनल नंबर. ओके, डेफिनेशन उतारते हैं, द नंबर विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी ओपन क्यू, दैट नंबर विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फ्रैक्शन. ओके, पी ओपन क्यू से 3/4, 1/2 ऐसा वाला नंबर क्या है, द नंबर विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी ओपन क्यू, वेयर कंडीशन है इधर, वेयर पी एंड क्यू आर इंटीजर्स. पी और क्यू क्या है, इंटीजर्स है, बट मगर क्यू जीरो नहीं होगा. क्यू या क्या किया मीन है, क्यू इक्वल टू जीरो ऐसा करने से not equal to 0 का ये सिंबल है. ओके, सो रैशनल नंबर क्या है? द नंबर विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी ओपन क्यू, वेयर पी एंड क्यू आर इंटीजर्स बट क्यू नॉट इक्वल टू 0. ओके, सो डेफिनेशन ये हुआ और इसके नोटेशन क्या है आप लिखते it is denoted by q. okay, capital q. The rational number is always denoted by capital q. so example, you can take many example, infinitely many. okay, so for example 5/4, this number can be written in the form of p open q फॉर्म में लिख सकते. देखिए p क्या है और क्या यहाँ कंडीशन क्या है अप्लाई, p एंड q आर इंटीजर्स. ये ध्यान रहे p और q क्या होना होता है, इंटीजर होना चाहिए, क्योंकि p क्या है 5 है, 5 इंटीजर है. q क्या है 4 है, 4 भी क्या है इंटीजर है. ये क्या है रैशनल नंबर है. p ओपन q फॉर्म में तो सभी नंबर लिख सकते क्योंकि उसमें इंटीजर होना जरूरी है. जैसे -5/2, देखिए -5 क्या है इंटीजर ही है. ठीक है, और एग्जांपल लेते हैं 1 भी क्या है ये इंटीजर ही, सॉरी रैशनल नंबर ही है, क्योंकि 1/1 हम लिख सकते हैं, क्योंकि 1 से डिवाइड करने से कुछ नहीं फर्क आता है, क्योंकि 1 ही आता है ना, इसलिए 1 भी क्या है इंटीजर. So let's take what about 0? 0 rational है या irrational है? और क्या है ये, क्या है rational ही है, क्योंकि हम जब 1 से denominator पर divide करते हैं तो ये क्या आता है 0 ही आता है, कुछ नहीं फर्क होता है, इसलिए 0 भी p open q form में लिख सकता है. 0 भी क्या k form में लिख सकते हैं, p ओपन q फॉर्म में लिख सकते हैं. सो इट कैन बी रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ p बाय q. सी q, व्हाट इज q, q इज 1. ये क्या, व्हाट इज दिस, दिस इज इंटीजर, एंड p इक्वल टू 0. p, व्हाट इज p, इट इज आल्सो इंटीजर, एंड हियर कंडीशन, लास्ट कंडीशन, q नॉट इक्वल टू 0. हियर द q मस्ट नॉट बी 0, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट q मस्ट नॉट बी 0. Here q is 1, so the condition is fulfilled. Okay, so 1 is all, 0 is also rational number. What about root 2? Okay, it can be written in the form of p open q, but p is not a integer. See root 2, it lies on somewhere here. Okay, the value lies somewhere here. Then root 3 also somewhere here. So it is not a rational number because p is not a integer. P is here also, p is not a integer, p is also not integer. So the definition is not fitted over here. So it is not a rational number because it cannot be written in the form of p open q, where p and q are integers. Okay, so here we have done example, you can take many examples. Okay, so rational number so far we have completed. So now irrational number. Or dusra definition bhi hai, definition DEFN shortcut, definition 2. okay, ye to hua 1 aur ye 2 definition rational number ka hi. So next definition, non terminating but repeating decimal expansion are called rational number. Non-terminating but repeating decimal expansions are called rational number. जैसा हमने कल लिया था 5/3, इसका डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन देखिए 5/3 क्या होता है, 5 3 1 3 2.0 3 3 6 18 2.0 means the number will be repeating, okay, 0. So it will be goes on like this, okay. So that's why 5/3 is rational number, because non-terminating, okay, the decimal expansion do not terminate, okay, ye terminate nahi hota hai, par kya hota hai ye decimal expansion, dekhi idhar se ye kya hota hai, repeat ho raha hai, ise hum aise bhi likh sakte hai 1.666. iska when we do this divide it will 1.666... okay, it can be written as 6 bar, okay. So this is rational number, okay. So this is the definition, and next topic have a look. Definition 1, the number which cannot be written, the number which cannot be written in the form of P upon Q, okay, the number which cannot be written, okay, in the form of P upon Q. I'll give a rational number. Irrational number are root 2 root 3 root 5, etc. Okay, root 5, okay. So this is irrational number, no doubt this is a irrational number. See what I am doing, it is in the form of P open Q, see P and Q, okay. What the definition is saying, the number which cannot be written in the form of P open Q, the irrational number can be written, but when there is a condition, okay, where P and Q are integers, see Q equal to 1, P equal to root 2. Q is integer but P is not an integer. We already know that P root 2 is not a integer. Point this, okay, note this. So here also P open Q form, it can be written, P open Q, it can be written. When the condition is applied, P and Q are integers, then it cannot be written in the form of P by Q, because P is not a integer, okay. So normal condition, but Q not equal to 0, okay. So I'll give an example, okay. Examples of irrational numbers, okay, root 2 root 3 root 5 root 6. What about root 4? Some might be wondering about root 4 root 1. You may do in your rough page, okay, to note. So what about root 4? As we know, 4 can be written as in a factor form, okay. Factor means the multiple, okay, multiple of 4. 4 can be factorized as 2 into 2 4 2 into 1 2. I mean it can be written like this, okay, 2 2 is 4, okay. So 2 into 2, when there is a pair in under root, okay, then there will be 2. The 2 will comes out from the under root. So 4 can be under root 4 can be written as, or simplified as, 2 by 2, and we can divide by 1. It can be written in the P open Q, because P and Q are both are integers, okay. So note that there is not always fixed that when there is a under root the number will be irrational. This not always, okay, the condition is not always for everyone, okay. So under root, when there is under root, like under root 16, it can be written as 4, okay, 4 4 is 16, okay. So 16 64 they are not irrational number. They can be rational number also. Okay, when there is under root, never think that it is always irrational number. Okay, they might be rational number. So it is conceptual. And root 1, what about root 1? Root 1, 1 into 1, what is 1? It is a rational number. Okay, root 1 also. Okay. So this is definition 1 is completed. Okay, in definition 2, see here. Definition 2, what non-terminating and non-repeating decimal expansion is called irrational number. Here what main point is, non-terminating, the number will not terminate, okay, and non-repeating, the decimal expansion will not repeat, okay, not repeat, is called irrational number. Such numbers are called irrational numbers. Okay, so in definition 1, we will distinguish between rational and irrational by looking, just physically examining. Okay, so here what we have to do, we have to divide two fraction. Okay, two fraction. If it is non-terminating, non-repeating, then it will be irrational number. So I'll give example. Okay, this for definition 2. Why we need two definition to explain the irrational number and as well as rational number. Okay, so what about pi? I'll give very famous or nice example, pi. What is the value of pi? Pi is 22/7. Okay, see, 22/7. Is it a rational or irrational? So pi is rational or irrational? What is pi? Pi is rational or irrational? It is irrational. How? Okay. See here, pi means 22/7. It can be written in the form of p open q. Okay. P open q. See, p and q are integer. Is it must be, pi must be rational. But what it will contradict? See, 22/7. When we divide this, It will go on, okay, like this. Here is, see, the decimal expansion will not terminate. It is here, okay, it will not terminate. Here what you see, 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, it will not repeat the expansion. Okay, okay, so what happens if the number is in the like this, which do not have terminating and non-repeating, this number cannot be in any sense, cannot be written in the form of p open q. So see here, definition 1 seems to be fail here, okay, seems to be failed. But from second definition we can define pi as a irrational number, because this decimal expansion, this pi has a decimal expansion having non-terminating and non-repeating decimal expansion. So the second definition will work here. Okay, so sometimes may ask why pi is irrational number. Okay, so at that time, you know, you need to justify by just pi is irrational number because by definition of irrational
number. It has non-terminating and non-terminating, okay? Non-terminating. If there is non-terminating but repeating, then it will be rational. If the number is non-terminating and non-repeating, then it will be irrational number. In case of pi, see what is the decimal expansion. This is for the justification. If somebody asks you why pi is irrational number, or is pi irrational number or rational number, you must answer pi is irrational number, because by the definition of irrational number, it has non-terminating and non-repeating decimal expansion. So you can justify like this, okay? You can do as much as, okay? So this is the complete set of irrational number, okay? So this is the basic term we have done so far, the basic term. So now we'll come to the term, okay? What is real number? Real number, it is simple. The number which is real, or the rational and irrational together is called real number. Okay, what is real number? Okay, we are defining what is real number. The rational and irrational number together, is called real number, okay? Or in simple language, you can say the combination of rational and irrational number. When two irrational and rational number combines, then it will form a real number, okay? So example, you can give example because you know the definition of rational and irrational too. So there is no problem. Root 2, 5 by 2, 6, 8, 5, anyone, pi, anyone, dot, or you can give so many examples of real number. So it is denoted by real R, okay, R. In case of irrational number, you can denote by I also, okay? So we are now in the main topic, okay? So our next topic will be Euclid's division lemma. Okay, what is Euclid's division lemma? So now the actual chapter started. Okay, so Euclid's, Euclid's, Euclid's division lemma. Okay, Euclid's means he is a mathematician, okay? Division means divide, lemma means, Euclid is a name of person, okay? Mathematician name. Division means divide, okay? Arithmetic division, divide. Lemma means proven, P-R-O-V-E, and proven statement used to prove another statement. Okay, lemma means the proven statement, okay, the statement which is already proven, okay? So for example, if we take this duster and this marker pen, okay? So when I lift here and when I drop this duster from a height, it will fall down, okay? I know the concept, okay, I know the statement. When I drop something from the earth surface, it will go down, okay. So this is proven, already proven, okay. When I drop this marker pen, it will go down, okay. It is already proven, okay. You can say this is the lemma, okay. Already the statement is proven, okay. So it will go down, okay. You can understand in this sense, okay. So here is the main theorem, okay, U-class division lemma. I will explain you one by one, okay. So given theorem one, theorem one, okay, unit only statement, okay. Given positive integers a and b, there exist unique integers q and r satisfying a equal to b. I'll write it here, a equal to b q plus r, 0 less than equal to r less than b, okay. So what is Euclid's division lemma? Already it is a proven statement, okay. This I'll explain with you an example, you will understand, okay. Given positive integer a and b, the positive integer, okay, it must be positive, there exists unique integers q and r satisfying this relation, okay. So I'll give one example. Say take an example of here I'll explain with example, okay. Here a equals to, say I will take any number 25 and b I will take 4, okay. Now what the Euclid's division lemma is saying, okay, the Euclid's division lemma is saying, given positive integer, this 25 and 4 is also positive integer, a and b, okay. I will take a as a greater number and b as a smaller number, okay. There exist unique integer. How it exists, okay? Now we must divide a, okay. We must divide 25 divided by 4. This is divisor, this is dividend. What I am actually doing is a divided by b. See, okay. I'll divide 4, 6 the 24, this is 1, okay. Here what, when I divide 25 by 4, here b by, when I divide a by b, when I divide 25 by 4, there exists, what is this? This is quotient, okay, quotient, here exists quotient. And what is this? This is remainder. See, what the division lemma is saying, when we divide something, we will get two unique number, okay. See, q and r, we are getting this q and this, we had only two numbers, okay. We have now extra two numbers, see, 6 and 1. What is 6? Quotient. What is r? Remainder, okay. So the division lemma is says only a equal to bq, okay. This is only the what I'll prove, okay. What is here a? A is 25, okay. 25 equals to, what is b? Here is 4, okay. What is q? Q is 6 plus, what is remainder? See, remainder is 1. So now we'll solve. 4 6 are 24, both marks, okay. Multiplication first. 4 6 are 24, then only addition. Sometimes the student might add 6 this number, it is wrong, okay. So both marks, first multiplication, then only addition. 4 6 are 24 plus 1, what is this? 25. See what the Euclid did, he gave simple division formula, okay, which is already proven. See, just now I have proven, okay. So this proven statement was given by the Euclid, okay. See here, what is the meaning of this, okay. Here I'll rewrite. What is remainder? See here, what is the remainder? Remainder is 1, which is greater than 0, okay, greater than 0 or equal to 0. So say if we take 24 by 4, then 4 6 are 24, remainder will be 0. So the remainder means the remainder can be equal to 0, okay, the remainder can be 0 or it will be greater than 0, not negative, okay, not less than. This means remainder is either equal to 0 or greater than 0, but always less than b. I mean to say always less than b, it should be always less than b. See, 4 is, this is b, 4 is greater than 1, 4 is greater than 0,